Good morning, sports fans! Sunday, Sunday, Sunday! Monster Trucks featuring Fordzilla and...
Actually, it's not Sunday. I believe it is Thursday, the day before I leave. So this is a special request from a really, really good friend of mine that I've known since high school, Mike Bromley. You know what? He said, hey, man, could you really do a quick play of the Ninja Turtles for NES? You know, I'm like, fuck, man, I have not played this game. Literally, I've not played this game since I was probably 12, maybe 13, so it has been years. But yeah, when he requested this, I just couldn't say no. One word comes to mind. Fuck yes. Alright, let's get started, guys. Alright, I have not... Oh shit, Chitella! That was a close call. Alright, so when I say I haven't played this in a long-ass time, I'm not just being like, oh, it feels like years. No, it's literally been fucking years since I've played this. Oh my god, as you can tell, my ankles are getting all torn to shit by these mousers. If you guys remember the mousers at all from the cartoon. Yeah. Anyway. Fucking mousers. So this is one of those side-scroller games. That's what I always loved. Hold on. Fucking Foot Clan, right? Ninjas in pink fucking onesies. Pink onesies. It's not very ninjatic, but it's pretty badass. You have to be very, very confident in yourself to go out fighting in fucking pink onesies. But anyway. The controls are a little stiff. I'm playing this on my original NES with its original controller. The thing about this game in particular is not like your typical side-scroller. In this game, you can't just go Rambo, plowing through everything, and expect them to come out alive. You kind of have to take your time a little bit with this game, because it's got all sorts of death traps, and just, yeah, like this shit here. I walked right into a goddamn pink sandwich. That pizza kind of helped, though, obviously. So yeah, you kind of have to watch your... See, look, see? Coming down the ladder, man. No fucking forgiveness. This game is merciless. It is one of the hardest games I remember playing as a kid, other than, like, Metroid and Castlevania. Man, it's just... See, look at this. See, yeah, you just... If you don't watch your step, you find yourself in very precarious situations, and you get fucked. So you can't just plow through here going Rambo, you know, like, just switching the full auto. You kind of have to take your time just a little bit. You don't screw yourself over. Oh, no. See, look. No prep time at all. I walk, and then fucking Bebop just gores me right in the face. Luckily, I had my Ninja Stars selected, though. That kind of helped. Rocksteady's taking off with my reporter poon, and I'm a little bit pissed off right now. So, I need to find some pizza. And look what we have here. Pizza on the top floor. This'll be fun. I do enjoy playing this game, though. For as nerve-wracking as it can be, for the pain in the ass that it can be, it really is a fun game. It's a classic game. The fucking music, I mean, come on, man. Like, anyone who grew up in this era, you hear this music, you know exactly what's, you know, what's in the gray box. This is Ninja Turtles for the NES, so. I mean, this, okay, here we go. Got Leatherface there. More pizza. Here we go.
Cowabunga!
You said it, Mikey. Even though technically I'm Leonardo, my least favorite of the Turtles. He was always kind of a self-important douchebag.
I'm the leader. Master Spencer left me in charge.
You said it again, Mikey. Now, actually, I love all the Turtles, but Leonardo was always my least favorite. Oh, shit. Come on. God damn it. Mm-hmm. You know, if I had thought to do that to begin with, select the Ninja Stars. Yeah. And, yeah, Chainsaw Chucky's back. Come on, shit, okay. Can I make it down the ladder? Oh, you fucker. All that to go to get pizza. I got the pizza, and I died on the way back, man. That's one hazardous trip to get some fucking munchies. That's all I gotta say. Raphael. Okay. Raphael is like my favorite turtle. I feel like he and I... Chainsaw Chucky. Psy versus Chainsaw. What do you guys think is gonna win? Psy won that battle. See, that's what this is one of those games where if you go off screen, like you go back in the other direction and then you walk back in the right direction, the enemies respawn. I always hated that shit. It was so monotonous, so tedious. Oh my god, come on. Playing like total noob sauce here. Raphael was always my favorite. He was always the one with the most attitude. He physically, I felt he was the strongest and just the most hard-nosed. And I relate to him in a lot of ways. Extra mana move. Oh, no, this is the thing that, like, I go in, like, a turtle spin. And as you can see the screen flickering, that would happen with some of these, like, older Nintendo games. Like, if there was too much going on, on the screen at one time, the shit would start to flicker. It, like, had problems keeping up with what was going on, and I'm already about to die again. As much as I love Raphael, the Psy is really a close-range weapon, and, just not really ideal for these kinds of situations, especially in any sort of side-scrolling game. And, yep, respawning, and I got fucked. Here's the crowd favorite, the one that most people tend to like, is Michelangelo. Ooh, no pizza. Cowabunga! How I prefer. So yeah, Michelangelo was obviously, like, the crowd favorite for most. Because of his fun-loving nature, his love of pizza, his surfer boy, like, California laid-back attitude. Nunchucks, in this game, not faring much better against these enemies as Raphael's size. But I'm gonna have to make do. Again, I kind of forgot how difficult this game can be. It's been forever. Oh, fuck, I remember this. Alright, if I can just kind of, like, play it safe. Can't remember if there's any pizza in this level. Yeah, one more hit. All somebody's gotta do is sneeze on me, and I'm pretty much turtle soup, so... For as complicated and difficult and just... get back up there! Kicked right in the turtle balls. Donatello. For as difficult as this game can be, it's still up. Here's Donatello. Another really, really, really close friend of mine that I've known for years. Michelle Clem. Donatello's always been her favorite, and I'm assuming it's because of his intellectual side. And apparently his intellect couldn't stop that. So, I think I'm done today.
Well, to be honest, I'm getting kind of bored with it.
Yeah.